Hello everyone, welcome to our fourth lecture. This lecture is based on examples on dynamics of synchronous machine. In last lecture we have derived swing equation or we have seen dynamics of synchronous machine. Now we'll solve problem based on that. Now the problem is given a 60 hertz 4 pole turbo generator rated 100 MVA 13.8 kV has inertia constant 10 megajoule per MVA. We need to find out stored energy, that means kinetic energy we need to find out. This we have to find out. Okay, kinetic energy. If the input to the generator is suddenly raised to 60 megawatt for the electrical load of 50 megawatt, find the rotor acceleration. Now here we need to find out in second case we need to find out alpha. Okay. In first case, we need to find out kinetic energy. Okay. Now, kinetic energy, we know it is G into H. Okay. So, in third, rotor acceleration calculated in part B. Now, if here we will calculate PA because mechanical input and electrical output is given. So, we will calculate PA, and from this, if the rotor acceleration calculated in part B is maintained for 12 cycles, find a change in torque angle and rotor speed in RPM at the end of this period. Okay, then fourth part is another generator of 150 MV having inertia constant 4 megajoule per MV is put in parallel with above generator. Find the inertia constant of the for the equivalent generator on the base of 50 MV. Now, as I told, stored energy can be calculated by kinetic energy into H. G is given, H is given. So we have calculated this value. Now acceleration is 60 minus 50, 10 megawatt. M is GH upon pi F if it is radian. GH upon 180 F, then the M will be in terms of electrical degree, megajoule second per electrical degree. Okay. Now M d2 del by dt square is there. Okay. So here PA we have calculated. Okay. Now from this we need to calculate alpha. We need to calculate alpha, and this we got 108 electrical degree per second square. Okay. Now in example, that acceleration is maintained for 12 cycles. It is maintained for 12 cycles. So 12 cycles, so 12 divided by 60, okay, 12 divided by 60 per minute, it is for per minute, so it is 12 divided by 60, it will be for 0.2 second. Now changes in the del will be 1 half alpha del t square. Del t already we have calculated in this section. Okay, so del t will get 2.16. okay, now from this we'll calculate alpha, 108 electrical degree per second square. Now we need to convert it to revolutions per minute. Okay, now we know 360 degree is equal to 1 revolution. Okay, 360 degree is equal to 1 revolution. So 1 degree will be equal to 1 divided by 360. Is it clear? Okay, now we have 108 degree. So it will be 108 divided by 360. Okay, got it? It will be 108 divided by 360. Now we need to convert into revolutions per minute. So we have multiplied with 60. We will get 18 revolutions per minute per second. Now rotor speed we need to calculate at the end of 12 cycles. We have synchronous speed 120 F by P plus changes due to this acceleration. That is 18 into 0.2. It is alpha T. This formula, this change in speed is alpha into del T. That timing is, this del T is for 12 cycles that we have converted into second. It is 0.2 second. Okay, changes in the del is 18 RPM per second. okay, it is maintained for 0.2 seconds. So it is revolutions per, it is for 0.2 seconds. So it is 18 into 0.2, you will get 1803.6 rpm changes due to changes in the mechanical input, changes in the del. Now H equivalent we need to calculate, because this we have asked. Another generator 150 MVA having inertia constant is put in parallel. Find out the inertia constant for the equivalent generator on the base of 50. So H1 into G1 divided by generator base plus H2 into G2 divided by base of MVA. Okay, system base. So this is 32 megajoule per MVA. You got it? Now example 2. Example 2, similar example is given. Okay, only changes is that this megajoule is changed. Okay, this input is changed. Okay, that means only 150 MVA is changed and this inertia constant is changed. Okay, remaining the formula remains same. Instead of 12 cycle, here it is given 10 cycles. So it will be maintained for 0.15. okay, that it is will maintained for 10 divided by 50 will be 0.2 second. 10 divided by 50 will be 0.2 second. Okay, now that acceleration is 13.88, okay, revolutions per minute per second. Okay, same problem, only values have changed. Okay, final speed will be 1502.776. okay, now third example. Now 250 are generating units operate in parallel within the same plant with the following ratings, unit 1, unit 2. Now we need to find out this H equivalent. So as I told, H equivalent we can find out by H1 plus H2. H1 will be H machine 1, H1 system will be H of machine 1 into G of machine 1 upon G system. H2 of, as in last lecture already, also in live lecture I told how to calculate H equivalent. H2 of system will be H2 of machine into G2 of machine. Okay, now this is equivalent inertia for on a base of 100 MVA and can be used when the two machines swinging currently. Okay, already we have derived this. Now this example, same example here, kinetic energy G1, here kinetic energy is given. G1 is G1 into H1 plus G2 into H2. Okay, G1, H1 is 4.6 megajoule per MVA, 4.6, 400 MVA, G2 is 3 and it is 1200 MVA. Okay, operates in parallel. So H equivalent we have calculated. Okay, that's all about the dynamics of synchronous machine. Similar problem you have to solve. Okay, thank you very much.